Please give it up for the pop punk renaissance leaders to talk all about their new music and touring. And for the first time ever on MTV, Edith, Taya, and Ada, also known as Meet Me at the Altar. Oh. I love the double bicep. Come on. How are you? Welcome to MTV.
Thank you.
We're so stoked to be here. I'm like out of breath. I know.
And we're just getting started. If you don't know, we did an IG Live when you guys were unsigned, just like on my personal Instagram like 2 years ago. And you just had one song out, I think at the time, Garden, or that was like the big one. And now you guys are just out of here. You're signed. You're doing like huge tours. We'll talk all about it. But just congratulations off the top.
Thank you so much. It's been absolutely insane.
Yeah, it's been crazy.
It's been crazy. So I want to talk to you guys about, of course, like the last time we talked and then to now. So much has changed. And this tour you're on right now with Knuckle Puck, and then you got the Jaden tour coming up, which is gonna be like out of here. How much have shows and just touring changed since like 2018 when you guys first hit the road?
Well, like in 2018, we were playing like five people.
Right.
Like quite literally.
And like a bar in Florida, somewhere weird.
Yeah.
So it's like, we went from like playing like five kids a night, like 10 kids, if you were lucky.
Yeah.
To like our first tour in August back after COVID, Coheed and Cambria. It was like, amphitheater, so it was a complete opposite of what we were doing before.
But do you guys find, I talked to so many artists that they say those shows back in Florida with five people, those are tougher than like Irving Plaza sold out.
Oh yeah.
It's so awkward when there's like, there's just people like right in front of you. You can see every single face that's there. It's like, I don't know, it's easier to just play to like a sea.
Oh, totally.
Of people. Yeah.
Because one of those five dudes check their phones, you're like, dude, what did I do?
It's like, don't look at us.
You guys did something so cool, and I feel like it's like so true to the roots of pop punk, because I discovered pop punk through like covers and also acoustic renditions of songs. And you guys just totally like acoustic remixed the Model Citizen EP. Mm-hmm. What brought that on?
I think we just wanted to give the songs a new life, because they're really deep, but the instrumentals themselves just sound super energetic and fun and happy. So we were like, why not make them like super soft and acoustic and pretty and really bring out the true meanings in the song.
Yeah, absolutely. And I also like, you know, like you guys are such great lyricists. It really puts the lyrics, like, no, but seriously, like front and center on an acoustic, because you might just be jamming out to the rock version of it, but the acoustic is, like you said, a whole new life. Not to, you know, freak you guys out, but you're on a pretty big bill this October in Vegas. When We Were Young Festival is so, I mean, this is so crazy, and we have a shot of it in the monitors. I mean, this lineup was so unreal. People thought it was like a prank. Like,
it's
gonna be Firefest Part 2, but no, this is quite literally happening.
Very real.
We got so many notifications. They were like, guys, it seems like a scam. Like, are you sure you want to play it?
People were messaging us like mad at us. We're like, why would you play it? It's such a scam, all this stuff. Like, no.
No, it's quite literally happening in Vegas. It's going to be insane. And you know, it's probably easier in fans' minds for you guys at these festivals to go check out other sets. You're very busy, so it's tough to sneak away. But if you could sneak away, I mean, just looking at this bill, who do you want to see the most?
My number one is Paramore. They will always be my number one. When we saw the lineup, and they were on it, I was like, oh my God.
Yeah. I would say Bring Me the Horizon, because that's the band that got me into like the scene in general.
Oh, totally.
Yeah.
Totally.
Yeah.
And I'd agree with both of them, but also Kitty.
Oh,
yeah.
I didn't even know Kitty was on the bill.
Kind of tiny font, but
That's
gonna
awesome.
Be exciting.
Looking ahead, or just looking back, actually, you know, it's International Women's Month. It was Women's History Month, I should say. It was International Women's Day this past week. You know, you guys are just such great torchbearers for being a fully female, you know, pop punk act. Do you have advice for young women that are looking to get into rock or pop punk, you know, male-dominated space?
Honestly, just do it. Like, it's just best to just get out there and just put your name out there, and anyone that's in your way, just bow them down and keep going.
Yeah.
That's what we did.
Hell yeah to that. Bow them down and keep going. Some wise words on Fresh Out. All right, we're gonna play a game here. You know, you guys obviously, you're on the road, you're spending a lot of time together. We wanna know how you guys really feel about each other. No pressure, guys. All right, so first question, who is most likely to show up late to rehearsal? Be honest.
Yeah, I feel like you'd just be getting ready.
I would be
getting
ready. Also, Edith has like the least to do because she just shows up and she's ready.
I would show up late on purpose because I don't have to do anything.
So are you late to everything?
No, I try not to be, but
Yeah.
A little bit.
All right, number two is, who is most likely to fall asleep in the middle of the afternoon?
It's either me or Taya.
I would say me. I fall asleep at like literally any function.
I feel like when you
we'd be asleep in the corner together.
Yeah.
Taking a nap.
If I need to knock out, I will knock out.
All right, let's do one last one really quick here, guys. Who is most likely to lose all their money playing the tables in Vegas after the When We Were Young Fest? Adam. Who's the risk taker?
Yeah.
Ada?
Why not?
It's the Jersey roots, the Atlantic City Jersey roots right there.
Let's go.
Well, guys, we're unfortunately out of time, but thank you so much. And this is so cool to do this from IG Live to now on MTV. They are Meet Me at the Altar, and you got to check out Model Citizen, both versions of the EP this weekend.